Hello everyone, my name is JMLisondra and today I'm going to teach you how to paint an underwater scene. You can see there's some corals, fishes and other things you can see underneath the ocean. Okay, and please don't forget to subscribe if subscribe it and hit the bell button if you want to receive some future notification of my new videos and tutorial. Okay, as you can see all the materials needed on the screen. You can see the 5 limit colors, the brushes that we're going to need and all the things that we need to paint this painting. Okay, so I'm going to start with the underpainting. I have here the number 12 nylon flat brush. It's a big brush, everyone. Okay, so you can also use bigger than this one, but this one I recommend because it's quite okay for this one. And I have here the blue color and the white there. So I never paint underwater for a very long time. And I think I remember I only have one underwater painting on my channel. So this is my second. You can also check for the first one, everyone, but I warn you that it's the quality is not too good. It's still it's an old video and the quality is 720, I think. Okay, so all you have to do is just fill this everything with the light blue color. There, I want to put more colors. I have here some blue. I will put a little red to make it darker. Yeah. There. Yeah, I really need a lot of blue here. Because I'm gonna fill everything here with blue first. With a little yellow and white. Yeah, I'll put a little greenish. So don't worry about this. This is just the underpainting. So all we have to do is fill everything with the bluish or blue green colors. So here I'm gonna put some distant coral reefs or something like that. So it will be just a bluish stone colors because since it's distant and mostly you cannot see colors there on the distance. Sorry everyone if there are plenty of noisy motorcycles outside. I don't really know why they have this kind of motorcycles. It's not good to have noisy motorcycles. Okay, so here I'm going to fill everything with this color. After 1 year, maybe I will have another studio, so I hope it will be quite studio. I think it will be way better than the studio here. There. A little greenish, also. Can put a little purple, everyone. Some red to make it purple, and you can also fill it up. There, so I am done with the underpainting. So I think I will just let it dry first before I'm going to add more details. I will let it dry first and we'll go back after 5 minutes. Okay, everyone, so I think the paint's already dry now and I'm going to start adding the details. I'm going to add more darks, lights, or whatever that I'm gonna need to put there. Okay, so I'll be using again this brush, the bigger brush that I used a while ago. Yeah, maybe I'll just try to make this part a little more darker or solid, because I think it's not solid yet. Blue and then white, a little yellow. What I like about adding the second coats, everyone, because it will make the color a lot more solid. I'm going to add a little raise here. Some sun rays from the top of the ocean. There, I'm going to put more blue, a little yellow. It must be a little bluish green, everyone. Oh, something like greenish also, but I don't want to make it greenish. I want it to be more blue green. There. Okay. More blue color. I'm gonna make this a little dark here. Okay, so I need to clean my brush, and here I'm gonna make this much more solid, and then to add one more blue color, and then I'm gonna put some more blue, and then some red to make it darker. Yeah, you can create the coral reefs here. You can create a coral reefs, distant coral reefs, by adding light colors or a little darker colors than the background. Yeah. But I want it to be darker. A little lighter than that. Yeah. And on this part, everyone, I'm going to put huge corals here. Yeah. So it will be a darker color. So I'm going to use a darker color now. Maybe I'll be using a smaller brush, the number 8 nylon flat brush. So I'll be using here the blue and the purple. So it will be here. So just blue and the red, everyone, to create the purple colors. So I'm going to put this in the sun. There. So just blue and red brown to make it purple, and it will be perfect. There. Yeah, I will not put plenty of corals there, maybe just a little, because I want it to be very clean inside the ocean. So here I'm going to put the sun, so it will be a little sun here on this part of the sea or on the bottom of the corals. So I think I'm gonna use this umber and a little blue and then white. There. Okay. And then I'm going to mix a little bluish. Yeah, just a little light blue with a little greenish. Yeah, it should be much more blue green for the distant sun there.
a little darker. Yeah, darker blue green. And also here. Okay. I'll try to do a little retouch on the bottom side. I'm going to make it I'm going to blend a little more. Here on this part. Okay, and then I'm going to retouch more on the sandy one, but I'm gonna make it lighter. So I'm gonna put blue umber and the blue and the white. And also on the other side. So I'm going to put a little light here. Okay, yeah, so I have now the sun there. You can see some colors on the sun at the bottom of the ocean. Okay, yeah, so here in the distance, everyone, I'm going to make it a little darker here. I also put some corals there, but it will be a lot lighter, or yeah, not so much the same with this. I'm going to put some white. Just make it darker here. Sorry everyone if there are plenty of noises in my background. This is a problem when I make tutorial at morning. There's always noises in the background that I cannot control. So here, I just put some dark. Then I will try to put some highlights on the other colors, corals. So I'll just make a little lighter color, blue green. Not so much. You can just create a topping technique, everyone, for this. That's it, and also here. Not too much light, make it a little darker. So just put a little lighter colors there, just to make it look like there's lights in these corals or some highlights. It looks like that there's plenty of colors there. Maybe I'll just make that a little more solid because I don't like the color one. It's not so solid. Okay, so here I'm going to put a little more lights for these corals. So that's why it's a bluish tone, everyone, or some little greenish or blue green, because the colors are in this tint, and also usually the visibility inside the ocean or under the underwater is so hot, so not so much. That's why you cannot see, even if just a few meters away, the colors become bluish or lighter. It's always like that in underneath the ocean. That's why we always putting their bluish color. Okay, so yeah, maybe this is already dry. I'm going to start adding a little details there. I'll be using a smaller brush, this one, number Nylon flat brush. And first, I'm going to use this raw umber and white. Maybe your raw umber and blue first. And to put a little highlights on this old coral. The color is combination of blue and the raw umber. There. Gonna put, also put some lights on the bottom. Touch it. Yeah, and a little greenish. I need to put more blue and yellow. Okay, and then some greenish, yellow and blue. I'll try to put some big corals, so maybe here. And much more bluish and white. I'll try to put in the top. Okay, and then I'll try to put a yellow green color maybe here. Can also put some red over here, not orange, not just this color. I want to put also some like orange color. Okay, yeah, it is becoming alive now, slowly and slowly, little by little. Okay, so I'll add more. I'll put more reddish. Thank you. Okay, so I'm gonna make it a little lighter, the orange. More yellow and red. Yeah, a little more orange. Little lights here on this little light orange, maybe red or light little pink color. You can actually use a smaller brush here, everyone, if you're having a hard time using this brush. Okay. I'll try to put some more light greenish. Maybe here. Okay. Also, I need to mix something like blue green and white. Yeah. Okay, also this one. There. Yeah, I'll try much more yellowish, everyone. There. Or maybe a brown. But maybe a brown is good. There. You can actually put a variety of colors, whatever you want here. Just to make it look more colorful, everyone. Yeah, looks good. Okay, so I want to add more. I will try purple because just blue and red, and then a little white, then you can have the purple. Or some red. Touch it. Okay, a little more here. Yeah, I think I will try to add more green, everyone. So here I have blue and the yellow. I'm only using one brush, everyone, but you can also use a smaller brush. So maybe I'll try to use a smaller brush now. I'll try to do it first, the light green. I'll try to put much more yellow. Just to make it look like there's plenty of thorns or something like that. I'm using a small brush. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, I think that looks good. Yeah, I will try to add more. I will add another kind of plant. So this one. Just a few details. But yeah, it's a little curly, everyone. Like a hair, something. Try to use some pink, just a white and red. Yeah, and some orange when I was trying to retouch. These ones look like a brain. So I can create like this details. Okay. And then, yeah, I'm not done yet, everyone. Still a lot of things to put there. A little pink here. And then a brown. Or some brownish tone. I'll try also here. Okay. There. Okay. Yeah. So it looks like now there's plenty of corals, different types of corals there on our underwater painting. Okay. And also here, little lights using the raw umber. And also maybe this one. Okay, sorry about the noises, everyone. Yeah, I think that looks good now, so far. Looks like good corals. Yeah, maybe I'll try to put something like, maybe I'll try to put some fish so that it will become much more happy. So my ocean will be much more like happy. Of course, it cannot be complete without those fish. Yeah, first I will try to put some orange fish, but it will be on a distant red and the yellow. This brush is broken. Yeah, maybe I need to use a smaller brush. Just like that, everyone, and it will really look like a fish in the distance. It will just look like some random color fish. Okay. And then I'm planning to put here one turtle. Yeah. will be beautiful. Yeah, he's coming towards us. There's one turtle here. And first, I will be using this raw umber and white, a little yellow. And I think blue. Okay, now I want it to be a little lighter. White under umber. With a little yellow, yeah. I am now doing the head part. Okay, I'll try to use a bigger brush, everyone, a flat brush. Yeah, this one. I'll try to use a little bluish and red, lighter purple. I'm going to add white. This will be the shell on the top. There. Okay. And then I'll try to use this bluish with a little greenish. and a little red. It must be dark, everyone, this part. Okay, now let's put more highlights, but I will be using a smaller brush again. Yeah, I'm going to put a little light. Be a little tricky, everyone, because this is a very small detail here. Yeah, I found this photo on the Pixabay. Maybe some other artist also was trying to copy this photo, but this is for free. Yellow on the rubber. Try to retouch this part here. And also here. That's it. I put much more yellow stone, everyone. And also here. So yeah, you can now see clearly that it looks like a turtle. Yeah. There. Okay. So I'm going to finish. Now the light is coming from the top, everyone. So I'll try to put a little darks. here I have blue umber and blue. And then I'm gonna put a little gray or white lighter. Trying to put some shades around or shadows. There. Or I'm trying to put some spots. There are also plenty of spots in the turtle. There. And a little lighter gray on the bottom part. Here. Some reflected light from the bottom. You can not overdo it. Maybe it's something like that. It will be enough. There. And now I'll put some more lights. Some more highlights. Maybe light there. There. These highlights will make it pop up. There. And also here, when you can also put some lines there. And also here. There. And then the other one. Yeah, then I'm gonna put a little light on the shell. Yeah, or maybe a little orange or yellow. Yeah, it's, I think it's yellow. There. So I think that looks good. It looks like a turtle now. Yeah, especially in the distance, it looks like a turtle and it's swimming through us. And it looks good. Turtle looks good. Okay, so I think I will try to put some more fish or something like that. Yeah. Okay, I'll try to put some more fish, everyone. So, I'll try to put other color fish, a light color, something like that. Okay. So, I'll try lighter color. Or like a bluish color fish. Maybe here. I'm using the bigger brush, everyone. I'll put also here. I'll also put some lights there, look like some fish. Yeah. Okay, so I'll try to find some other fish, everyone, to put it there. Yeah, maybe a clownfish or... Yeah, maybe here. There. And then I'll try to add some details. So here I have this blue and the red. Little white, it's too much dark. Eyes here. So I can put the stripes. I think you know this fish. That's it. And also this one. There. And on the top of that fish, I'm gonna put a little yellowish. Yeah, I have here some yellow and a white. or maybe a little greenish. And also this one. Yeah, I'm gonna make it a little lighter. So we have no other variety of fish, everyone. Yeah. Time check is 1 hour, more than 1 hour now, and I will need to continue more. I'm going to add more things there, just to make this much more alive. Yeah. Maybe I'll try to also to put some dark fish. Or dark, or maybe black. Blue and the umber. No, blue and the red. Can use that. More red. There. Yeah. There. You can actually use a smaller brush even if this brush is hard for you. Okay. Okay, I'll add more, maybe some red fish. Yeah, I just try to put some splotches of red just to make it look like there are plenty of fish there. Okay. Yeah. Not just there, I'm also to put some fish here on the top of that, but it will be much more like silver or light blue something. So I have here some blue and the red, the purple and the white. chalice. Some dark patches, everyone. And then we can also put some lights there. Those reflected colors. Maybe some just light blue. Okay, and maybe a little lighter. There. Yeah. Okay, so I will try to put more, everyone. I think I will try to put some bubbles here. Yeah. Yeah, it will be a lot there. It will be new. So I'll try to use some light blue. Maybe here. Okay, you can also put some tiny bubbles like this. Just like a white light spots here, everyone, like this. I'm gonna use some white. Okay. There. Everyone, so I think I'm almost done. I'll just try to retouch the fish, and then yeah, I need to clean my brush. I have here some yellow, and then red, and then a little white. Yeah, I just have to put some highlights on the fish. Okay, so I don't know what I'm going to put more everyone's, but I think I'm very content in the entire result. Maybe some more highlights and then I'll be done. Some highlights of the rocks. Yeah, this is my final retouch. So here, I'm gonna make a little lighter yellow. Try to retouch some light green, everyone. So here I'm gonna put little highlights on the top. There. And also here on the bottom. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm going to put a little highlights on the purple. Yeah, no blue. There. And also here. Okay. Yeah, I think that will be good, everyone. Okay, so I think I am contented and I think the entire result looks good. It's just so simple, not so much complicated, and yeah, I like the turtle. It looks good there. It's on the right spot, the right composition, which is really good, and also the background looks really good, and the fish, plenty of things there. You can see that it's a healthy coral reefs, and the fish there are healthy, and the entire ocean are healthy. Okay.
Okay everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.